Twice a year, Australia's big retailers throw a lavish bash to launch their seasonal fashion collections. And David Jones is first out of the gate this year with Autumn Winter. Star recruit Miranda Kerr flew in from the US without her two favourite boys, hubby Orlando and son Flynn, to help celebrate the store's 175th birthday.
What is in store for this season?
Well, there's a lot of colour actually for this season. A lot, also white on white, it's not all about black. And a lot of sculptured pieces that fit to your body shape, which is nice.
Tonight it's all about military green and burgundy.
What about shapes?
Shapes like this is caliber, very thinly cut, tapered legs. Look out for Jack London. Jack London have some pretty suits.
So you don't mind a bit of fashion, so you're going to get to look at the parade too?
I am. I saw the rehearsal and I've already sort of earmarked what I want. But yeah, it's really beautiful this year. It's really beautiful.
And who's this beautiful number one?
This is Lover. They're one of my favourite Australian designers. Lover.
Black is the new black.
No.
Yes, black is the new black. Black with a little bit of white or a little bit of like a little bit of red or a little bit of beading. But I just think it's the colour that works the best for me in winter. Girls love it. We can pretend that we're going to do something else, but they just want a great little black Alex Perry dress.
What are some of the other trends we should look out for?
I think with textures, there's a lot of lace, sequins, and studs. And I think there's a trend that I'm hearing a lot of, this Great Gatsby deco inspired style, which is super chic, very sophisticated and comfortable as well. So I love to see how David Jones have interpreted that tonight.
And what's in store from you, Colette?
Well, it's a mix of our beautiful iris print, lots of colour, and I guess it has its light kind of 60s feel that's coming through from everywhere else. And then, of course, lace in different ways, so...
Colour for autumn, winter?
For us, yes. A lot of navy instead of black, actually, and iris print, which is beautiful jacarandas and iris blues, Monet's garden.
Beautiful.
We're going to be seeing some fabulous colour. We've had a little look backstage, and, of course, David Jones are renowned for doing great colour. We'll see a lot of wonderful evening dresses as well. I think David Jones are going to go all out. Being the 175th anniversary, I think we're going to be seeing a lot of dresses to celebrate in.
175 years, let's do it right.
175 years, and this is actually my ninth season in a row as the ambassador for David Jones, the fashion ambassador. So they are like family to me, and we're all quite excited here at the David Jones show, and it's a really glamorous atmosphere, as you can see on the catwalk, and really wonderful things from Australian designers that I've grown up with and I'm proud to be associated with.
Well, your body shape's the best in the business and this dress fits beautifully. Who's it by? Tell us about the whole look.
Ellery, which is really exciting that we have Ellery on board this season, and it's all about accessorising with this statement shoe this winter. And and the colour. Apparently this colour is called Biscuit.
Biscuit?
Yeah, just like a cup of tea and a biscuit.
Good enough to eat, some might say. Tell you what, some really nice shots came out of you today in a Victoria's Secret bridal underwear collection.
It's kind of funny, isn't it?
Looks amazing. What's it like modelling for something like that? Do you get stressed?
You just have fun with it.
Do
it's
you?
Look, I've been doing this since I was 13, and I just, at this point, you just have to have fun with it, and life's about living and enjoying yourself.
In the 1970s, Helmut Newton transformed the world of fashion photography with his confronting and risque images that showed women as strong, physical, and often in various states of undress. He spent two decades of his life in Australia, where he met and married his wife, known as Alice Springs. And a new exhibition here is capturing some of the best of his groundbreaking work. He's the artist who changed fashion photography forever.
Before Helmut Newton, fashion photography was really quite polite.
And Bettina Reams is the photographer who loved androgyny.
From my point of view as a photography curator, the camera always lies, and this is a great example.
Their work features in a new free exhibition at the Art Gallery of New South Wales, celebrating groundbreaking photography. German-born Helmut Newton lived in Australia in the 40s and 50s, where he met and married his wife, known as Alice Springs, before moving to Europe.
In his heyday, Newton was accused of being sexist and being kinky and pornographic and so on.
Alien star Sigourney Weaver was one of his models, and the pictures were always surprising.
It's actually not a woman, it's a mannequin. And the hand that the man is kissing is actually detached from the body.
For photographs that often featured scenes of bondage, fetishism and voyeurism, to make it onto the pages of a mainstream fashion magazine like Vogue in the 70s was nothing short of 50 shades of sensational.
I can remember buying Vogue magazine in the 1970s and looking at the pictures and going, oh my God.
Angela Bishop, 10 News. Unless you actually care about the game, when most people think of the Super Bowl, they think halftime entertainment and the ads. But there's one other thing worth taking a look at, the Super Bowl movie trailers. Here's a selection of the best.
You think your world is safe? It is not.
Get back in your car right now!
You'll never see me coming.
Lot of apologies to make.
You're the only one strong enough to save us all.
We're getting out of here.
Hey, you believe in ghosts?
I can reach out and break you whenever I want.
That's Dave's talk.
Going somewhere?
Yes.
No, we are not.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Shut up!
Yes.
That might have been more extensive than extended.
That's all for now. See you next time.